Teresa.
She just put tears in my eyes. I didn't want to come down here, and it's tough because as an artist, as a rapper, as a community person, they always feel like when you're doing something, you're doing it for personal reasons. And in my mind, I was like, I don't want to go down there because I don't want people to feel like I'm doing this for me. And I stand up here so selfless right now, and I stand up here so selfless. I stand up here with tears in my eyes from hearing a poem from a sister who I don't know, but it just touched me so much. And I just hugged her like that was my mama daughter. I want y'all to know this though. Everybody that stands on the side of you not standing with you. If you're not here for the sole purpose of us raising awareness and representing and singing so loud and spiritually so walking so loud that our ancestors is proud, if you're not here for that reason, we ask y'all to leave right now. If you're not here because you're deeply affected by it, now listen, all people come from black men, so I don't care what color are you. I don't care what color you are, because all people come from black men. We are the original people. So let's not get caught up in shades. Let's get caught up in purpose. What's your intentions? What is your reason? Is it self-inflicted indigenous? What is your reason? Are you here to all the indigenous people that are natives to this land? To all of the people that come from this earth? To all of the people that represent cry and pain? To all of the people that shed tears when they see somebody that they don't know slain in front of somebody? Racism is taught. Racism is perpetuated hate that is passed on through tradition. We cannot be called guilty of racism because we're not teaching that. We're representing love. We stand on love. We stand on love. I say this to all of my peers and all of my friends. White silence is still violence. I don't care within the proximity of who you are, of your relationship. If you are me and you are my brother, regardless of your color, if you know that you have a different pigmentation that gives you the right affiliation, utilize that. Utilize your privilege to speak for us. Utilize your privilege to do things on a platform that we can't do due to the pigmentation.
Okay. What happened? What happened?
Of course. My obligation is to my pigmentation, and I am unapologetically black, so I'm sorry if you are offended by that. They ask me what life will I save first, if it's black or white. I'm sorry, I'm gonna save black. I'm sorry, but I'm not sorry. I'm standing for my people, just like you should. But we are appreciative for those that are non-black that are here today. We are appreciative because we know how much risk that it takes. We know, as standing in solidarity, how you can be blamed, how you can be labeled. We know the risk that it takes from your family members saying you're willing to lose your life for strangers. We know. We know what the risk is for anyone that's out here. We know what you're risking standing in solidarity with us, and we are appreciative. We're thankful. But please, let us not lose sight of what we're fighting for. A protest without a plan and a list of demands is more like a parade. We're not here parading. Let me hear everybody say, this is not a parade. We're not here to parade, y'all. Because you parade when you're celebrating something. We're not celebrating nothing. We're standing here with our demands, and we're sitting up to see the cease of police brutality. The cease of those are able to kill us and lynch us. That's the new modern day lynching. Them shooting us on camera. Them killing us, assassinating us. That's assassination. That's nothing to celebrate. We are here because we fed up. We have reached our boiling point, America. This is a mirror to the hate that we've been gave. So when the president tweets out things like these thugs are tearing up Minneapolis, but they tweet out the citizens of Pennsylvania demand their rights when they marching with AR-15s and deadly assault rifles, but they call them citizens and people, we see where we stand. We not thugs. I see beautiful people out here. I see kings and queens. I see activists. I see passionate people. I see mothers, fathers, sons, daughters. I see the people that say we're not going for it no more, man. If we gotta burn this motherfucker down, that's what they gonna do. They're not going for it no more. In Oakland, in Detroit, in Baltimore, in D.C., in New York, in Minneapolis, in Florida, in Miami, what you're seeing is rage. We have reached our boiling point, America. Don't blame us for this. Don't blame us. What I want to say to all of my scholars and to all of my young people that are out here today, the youth has the power. We have the ability to change. We have the ability to switch the narrative. We have the ability to change the way America will be looked at and viewed. It starts today. The shift of the power is us appreciating our power. Because remember, the power is in the people and politics we address. I love you, Patrick. The power is in the people and politics we address. For us to stand here, that means we all got some things that we need to address. I love you guys so much. I'm not here to incite no riot. I'm here to say, let's get a plan. Let's organize it. Let's be effective. Let's sit up and let's say, hey, this is what we want. This is what's going on. We have the ability to change the narrative. Before I go, I want to send a humongous shout out to the young organizers that organized this rally. So when they say we can't come together in peace and in solidarity, when we can't come together with demonstrations to spread love, that's a lie. If your intentions are negative, please exit stage left. We here because we have reached our America. Let's remain conscious of what we do. Oakland, California, the home of the Panthers. Organizing ain't nothing new for us. I don't care if you black, white, Latino, Middle Eastern, Asian descent, Polynese, whatever you represent, today you stand in solidarity with one cause: to see the cease of police brutality in a corrupt judicial system that continuously shows us that they don't give a fuck about us. All power to the people. Because we have reached our boiling point, America.